Good morning students. So today we'll see how to draw the influence line diagram for middle support B of a continuous beam shown in figure, and you have to compute the ordinates at every 1 meter interval. So last problem in lecture 3, again we had a continuous beam and we drew the ILD, or we calculated the influence line ordinates for reaction at A, which was a combination of triangle. So it had positive values for AB portion and triangle portion for AB, ranging from 1 at A to 0 at B, and at B to C it had a semicircle like shape. So B and C 0, and again all negative values. Now for this middle support, if you draw the ILD, it will have only positive values, so A and C 0, and at B portion will be equal to 1. So if you know the ILD diagram, as I already told you, we can find out whether you are proceeding right or wrong when you get the answers. So coming back to the problem, so ABC, so now for the reaction at the middle support B, we have to draw the influence line ordinates. Hence, we have to remove the reaction at support B, or we have to remove the support B, and then we have to apply unit load. Again, it consists of two portions, AB and BC. So as we do in Michaelis method, we have to have a dotted line to distinguish between the two parts. So this is a given data, the continuous beam ABC with AB and BC equal to 5 meters. So as I already told you, we are going to apply Muller-Breslau principles. And the formula is IL ordinates for RB is equal to YXB by YBB. Why do we have YBB at the denominator? Because we are only applying unit force. So again, we consider any section XX at X distance from C. So before we do all this, there is a continuous beam ABC. So we have to first calculate the reactions. So RB equal to 1. To find RA, let us take the moment of all forces about C, clockwise positive, anticlockwise negative. So it will be RA into 10 and plus 1 into 5 meters. So RA equal to minus 1 by 2 or minus 0.5. Then to find RC, we apply summation V equal to 0, upward equal to downward. So RC is also equal to minus 0.5. So having these reactions and marking the values of the reactions diagram, now we proceed to find the moment at X. So moment X is equal to minus EI d squared y by dx squared. So for the first part, it is RC into X. And for the second part, it is RB into X minus 5. So RC is equal to minus 0.5, RB equal to plus 1. We apply those values and simplifying, we get EI d squared y by dx squared equal to 0.5x minus X minus 5. So dotted line is for the part. So again we integrate to get EI dy by dx, and again if we integrate we get y. So purpose here is to get yxb by ybb. So the equation 2 is NF, and again we have to apply the boundary conditions to find c1 and c2, and you will be remembering that you have to add the constants of integration c1 and c2 only in the first part and not in the second part. So again see the diagram. So this is also a deflection diagram. The ILD is also a displacement of the deflection diagram. So at A and C, the displacement y equal to 0. So that will be the boundary condition. At C, x equal to 0, y equal to 0. At A, x equal to 10 meters and y equal to 0. So x is equal to 0, y equal to 0 at support C. X equal to 10 and y equal to 0 at support A. So first we'll apply x equal to 0, y equal to 0 in the second equation, which is EI into y equation. So we get C2 is equal to 0, and we have to apply only the first part. So for x varying from 0 to 5, that is for first part only. So more than 5 only, you have to consider the second part. So 0 to 5, from C to B, you have to consider only the first part. For x values greater than 5 only, you have to consider the second part also. So you are considering the portion within the first part. So beyond the dotted line, you're not considering. Ci y equal to 0.5 x cube by 6 plus c1 x plus c2. So here if you apply y equal to 0 at x equal to 0, you get c2 equal to 0. Then you have to apply x equal to 10 and y equal to 0. So for this, you have to consider the entire equation because the value of x is greater than 5. So when you find out, you get c1 equal to minus 6.25. So apply these values in Aiy equation. You get the value for y, which is also yxb. Now how do we get ybb? At b, what is x? At b, x equal to 5. So apply x equal to 5. And again, you can consider only part 1. So here it is a mistake. You consider only part 1. So only for values greater than 5, you have to consider both parts. So again, we get IL ordinates for rb equal to yxb, ybb. So equation, again, you have to apply the values ranging from x equal to 0, 1, 2 and so on till 10 meters. So interval is 10 meter. Again, the table gives the ordinates of rb for various values. Again, you can see at c it is equal to 0, at a it is equal to 0, at b it is equal to 1. So if we consider from c, the values keep on increasing till the maximum value 1 and it decreases. And as it is symmetrical, AB is equal to BC, the values are same. See, at C it is equal to 0, A also equal to 0, the next value is 0.296, there also it is 296. This is because it is symmetrical. We are considering the middle support B. It is actually at the middle of the continuous span. Okay, thank you, and I will give you an assignment problem also. Thank you.